Well, hi everyone, Rick from WingStuff.com, and welcome to the first ever WingStuff Remote Rally, July 1st through July 8th, the entire week of Independence Day holiday. We're going to be having Independence Day deals on hundreds of our most popular items. We're also going to be offering double wing reward points on every dollar you spend. And then we're going to have me and my wing photo contest where you can win all kinds of prizes. I mean expensive stuff. We have more prizes that we're giving away, expensive prizes, than we've ever had in the history of the company. So I think you're going to really like this. We also have vendor videos, which you're going to get up close and personal with all the brands and manufacturers that we sell to you, and you're going to get the inside view from them, what they're up to, new products, a little bit about their companies, and that's coming up next. So stay tuned.
Hi everyone, welcome to the WingStuff Virtual Rally. I'm Arrow, I'm founder of Goldstrike, and I brought a couple new Goldwings out to show you everything we offer for them. So we'll start on the blue bike here, kind of go front to back. We offer everything from chrome accessories to a lot of lighting as well as comfort items. So if you want to check out this first part here, it's the windshield strut cover. It's an easy 3M stick-on piece, installs in about 2 minutes. Fun fact about 3M is that they're located about only 20 minutes from our office. So we actually get to work with their engineers and they recommend the perfect adhesives to install our accessories so that they don't fall off. Because you need a different type of adhesive depending on if you're going right to paint versus this slippery or plastic. Next we've got the mirror accents. So you can see that's available in chrome or black. Moving down, got the radiator intake trim, as well as the running lights with the built-in turn signal. Next, we have the front fork covers, which actually bolt right on over the factory fork. They feature a removable window here, so you can actually display your reflector, or we have a lighted accent that goes in place of that, which you can see on the other side of the fork here. Keep moving down the front, we have the rotor cover, which is one of my favorite pieces. I like this one so much because it gives you so much side visibility. From the factory, these bikes don't have very much lighting on the side at all, and so this really draws a lot of attention. That's a running light as well as a turn signal, and it fits perfectly with the caliper covers here, which we actually designed to be vented. So you've got intakes here, as well as another cutout in the back to keep your brakes nice and cool. If you want even more chrome at the front, have some vent accents here, as well as the front fender tip. Those are available chrome or black. Next, in the same area that's really hidden, is the tie-down bracket, which actually bolts directly to the frame of the bike. Makes it much easier to tie your bike down. It's stamped steel, so super strong, it's not going anywhere. We have the chrome fog light trim accent. This fits with or without fog lights installed. We've got the crash guard chrome. We've got the lighted engine accent, which is a running and a turn signal. And we've also got a shock and awe add-on for it, which is our multicolor LED system, which you can see here. That'll go any color, hooks up with Bluetooth or a manual controller, so you can accent your bike as well. Up here, got a couple more small vent trims. And then a nice new accent is right here on the speaker. Got some brand new chrome speaker grills designed to match the styling of the bike. You can see it's got kind of this little wing in the center. Really dresses up that speaker. Got the master cylinder cover, as well as the center dash cover. And then if you want to check out other handlebar accessories, We've got our drink holder, which is super popular. It's a nice soft neoprene rubber, so if it touches anything, it won't scratch your tank. It's available in two sizes, chrome or black. This is the smaller one. We've got a larger one as well. It works well with the tumblers, the big Yetis, pretty much anything you want to carry in it. We've got the perch mount available to mount it, which works with any Goldwing, previous generations, any year. So that mounts on the right or the left side if it's not a DCT bike. We've got a swivel on the top here so you can adjust the angle. Use it with multiple different accessories. On this side, this is the specialized DCT mount. So that's a cast aluminum, kind of half clamp piece, and that'll just bolt right onto your bike and allow you to use our phone holder, which on the bottom of this one actually has a USB port, so you can charge your phone as you're riding. We offer it unpowered as well, and it's super easy to use because you just adjust this lever. Twisting it one way will increase the width, twisting it the other will decrease it, and then you slide your phone in from the top, flip this lever down, and now your phone's locked in. The brand new version of this is actually called the Cybercharger on the red bike over here. And this one's my favorite because super easy to use, same concept. You just slide your phone in from the top, and it's actually got the wireless charging coils right in the back there. So you can see it's fast charging now. So it's 15 watt, and it'll get your phone charged up real quick. Well, we're up in this bars area. We also have these brand new grips, which are nice. They clamp right over the factory grips, and the rubber is heat transfer, so your heated grips are still felt nice and warm right through the factory, right through these covers. Down on the center of the bike, you have the frame accent. Goes over the factory frame and dresses that up. We've also got the passenger adjustable peg mounts, so you've got splines right here, as well as right here, so you can bring that back or push it forward. Make sure your passenger is comfortable. We've got the driver floorboards to match, as well as the brake cover. And then one of my other favorite pieces, the frame mounted highway pegs. This you can see is also very adjustable. You have splines right here, as well as right here. So there's a lot of movement. You can bring it way forward if you want your legs stretched out more, or you can bring it back pretty close to the factory floorboards. I'll show you what that looks like off the bike because most of the mounting is actually hidden. So here we have the factory crash guard, and our part actually bolts directly to your frame right here and then clamps around that crash guard. You've also got a slide right here that moves back and forward about 3 inches. So you just choose your location, bolt it right on there, and then you've got your splines right here and here for adjustment. This peg also has a little bit of a kickback here, so it keeps your foot nice and steady on there, and you don't have your foot wanting to slide off the edge. Let's see if we go to the back here. This is a cool new accessory as well. Mounts right to the factory tour pack. We also have a bunch of other mounting options for luggage racks, clamp mounts, anything like that. And you can see the flag is actually illuminated by these white LEDs here. So that's a really cool effect at night. The next thing we have here is the passenger armrests. Those go right into those factory holes and bolt on, so it's super easy to install. And you've also got this accessory port, which you can use our drink holder with. It's nice because it swivels, so when you open your trunk, your drink doesn't spill. Next piece here is the tour blade. So you can see this is run, turn, and brake. So you got, there's your brakes, running light, and the turn signal is actually sequential amber, which we think really helps draw your eye when you're behind the bike. And it matches the factory amber signals as well. We've got the trunk light right here in chrome or black. This works well with the luggage racks because it sits down below there and it just blends right into the bike's body line. So it looks just OEM, super clean. Got the accents here for the tail light, as well as the license plate light accent, reflector replacement light, license plate frame, as well as the filler panel lights with a nice plasma amber signal built in there and a bunch of red LEDs, so you're super visible from the back. We've got the fender tip accent, as well as the mud flap, which is nice
durable rubber, and it's got a couple lines on the back as a template so you can cut it and use it with trailer hitches as well. Hidden kind of behind these filler panel lights are the actual rubber fillers. And those are nice because they slide up the edge of the fender and just bolt right on from the back, so there's no visible hardware and it fills that gap that the factory left there. One more piece at the back here is the saddlebag accent lights. As you can see, we've really done a lot of work with the optics in here, like we try to do with most of our lighting accessories. Build a lot of cool optics into the lens, which is also made out of polycarbonate, so it's shatterproof, just like your OEM headlights, things like that. So it's high quality, it's lifetime warranty on all the LEDs, so you don't have to worry about anything going out. I'll show you the LED accessory lighting plug is actually using Honda OEM connectors. So everything is plug and play and is labeled left and right. You'll get two of these in the kit to plug all your lighting accessories into. And you have four outputs, so you can use four pairs of lights with just one of these plug and play kits. And then if you want to take a look at the black bike, this is just a representation of all our black accessories since everything's getting so popular in black as well, and it looks really good contrasting with the paint of the bike. Another piece we have here is the front fender extension, which is super easy to install. It just bolts right onto the factory fender and gives you a little more protection for that stuff right behind the tire. Yep, so that's about all I have for you guys. But appreciate you stopping by and watching the Goldstrike segment. Thank you.
Good morning, I'm Fred Harmon from Angel Ride Enterprise, and this is my workshop. Today I'm in the process of replacing shocks on a 2018. This one has a manual transmission. And just want to also mention I make and sell maintenance videos for both the new Goldwing and previous generation Goldwing. And those are for sale on WingStuff.com's website. I show you lots of details in those videos about how the bike comes apart, and more importantly, how to put it back together properly. Well, I've got you here. Let me just show you a real quick technical tip that I've developed. I'm getting ready to remove the side panel from the motorcycle, and I'll just make this real quick, but one of the challenges in removing the side panel is there's little clips hidden underneath this edge that are hard to release, and the way I release them is I take a plastic credit card and I wrap a little towel around it so it won't scratch, and I slide that credit card under that edge to release that panel. And that allows me to get this panel completely off the motorcycle. So that's just a little taste of some of the technical tips and things that I'll show you in my videos. I also work on these bikes, so I get a, you know, I do quite a few different jobs on these bikes. I've probably done about 25 or 30 of them now, so I've learned a lot of little tips and tricks along the way to getting the plastic on and off properly without breaking things and getting the bike back together. The bike's not actually as hard to work on as it looks like it is. It's a little intimidating at first, but once you see how things come apart and go back together, it makes it a whole lot easier when you actually go do the work. So anyway, that's about all I have. I've got a big job in front of me today, so I'm going to have to get back to work, but just thought I'd let you drop in on me and see what I'm up to. So you guys take care and ride safe out there.
Baker of Baker Built Air Wings. I am happy to be here at the WingStuff remote rally. We were the first company to make adjustable air deflection for your motorcycles. They are designed to keep you warm in cold and wet weather. Normally the cold or water comes right through here if you don't have these on, but with these on here, your cold and rain goes out past you. You can ride in a fairly heavy rain and stay completely dry, especially if you got the foot wings on. Your feet don't even get wet right in the rain. The only time your feet would get wet is you had to stop and put your feet down when the road was real wet. We've actually literally got you covered from head to toe. We've got the deflector that fits on the windshield. It does a great job. Takes the air out past your arms, your shoulders. Keeps a lot of the air off your passenger's head and shoulders. And especially the ladies have long hair, as keeps her hair from blowing all around. For hot weather, when you want air in, all you open these up and it brings that air right in on your chest. You absolutely get all the air you want. We have here what we call an adjustable hand guard. It does a great job of blocking that cold air that would come through here. It keeps you a lot warmer. For hot weather, you open them up and this brings that air right in on your hands and on your arms. So it makes a great advantage. It's designed to fit the contour of your cycle. Goes around the light the way it's shaped here. We feel we got about a perfect match. The next one we refer to is a hand wing. This hand wing fits under your mirror, takes that air off your shoulders, off your legs and hips, does a great job for hot weather. Here again, you open it up in hot weather, it brings that air in. The other big feature advantage of this, it's actually designed to fit the exact contour of your motorcycle. We have what we call an air wing with blowers. The air wing like this is what we originally designed for the motorcycles back in 82. We put them on the market in 83. We've been selling them for about the last 45 years. For hot weather, I'd like to keep this enclosed in hot weather because you get a lot of extreme amount of heat coming out of here. With this like this, it brings this heat out here rather than coming up on you. Now, for medium weather, when it's not extremely hot, or like early in the morning, you can open them up or bring a little heat back in on you. But for the most part, I generally run them in the closed position. The leg wing, we've got a little wider one for a trike wing. This blocks that cold air from coming through here on your legs and on your ankles, and especially your passenger. This one here will keep a lot of air, cold air and rain off your passenger's legs and feet. And here again, they're adjustable. You get into hot weather, you can open these up, brings that air right in on you. The foot wings is a great addition too. With these foot wings, these just snap on and off. All I gotta do, take them off, I just push down and they'll snap off. But this will literally actually keep your feet dry when you're riding in the rain. For hot weather, when you don't want them on there, they just literally snap off real easy. So really, when I tell you that we've got you covered from head to toe, we literally do. Got you covered to keep the air off of you, and you got them covered to bring the air in on you. We do a lot of motorcycle rallies, especially the wingdings. Most of the years at the wingdings, I'll go out and do a survey in the parking lot, and probably 60-70% of the goldwings have air deflectors on them. But on the average, our air deflectors outsell the competitors approximately 10 to 1. So we feel we've got a good product. We got another back here that's very helpful. These passenger hand grips is extremely helpful. The original design, you can't even get your hand around the grip. But with this here, especially if you're a little larger like I am, you can sit on there and get an extremely good grip on them. They're very solid. There's no holes to be able to put them on. You just put them on and tighten a couple screws. We have a luggage rack available. Obviously, this only works on the models that don't have the trunk on. But all you do is drill a couple holes in this here little cover piece here, and it's flattened underneath. So you just drill a couple holes and put the screws in. So we feel you've really got you covered. We also have a couple different styles of cup holders available. These are very popular. Also have a feature on this, and it's very valuable. It's different than the original factory center stand, because I can stand here beside this. It's real easy with about 10 pound pressure, put this up on the center stand. The other great thing about this, I can get on the bike, put it in gear, and take off. I don't even have to put the center stand up, it automatically comes up. Watch that center stand here, and pretend you're on the bike and watch it come up. The spring needs a little bit of adjustment. The other great feature is our hand wings. These are very popular. It gives your passenger a good place to hold on to. It gives you a lot more security. You got any questions? All our products are made in the United States. You'll find a complete line of these products at WingStuff.com.
Welcome to the WingStuff Remote Rally. I'm Brandon Westfall with Big Bike Parts and Show Chrome Accessories. We're here today to talk to you about what Big Bike Parts has to offer for your motorcycle. Big Bike Parts has been part of the motorcycle industry for over 39 years, designing and manufacturing leading accessories for the marketplace. Big Bike Parts manufacturing consists of Show Chrome Accessories, which is our line of chrome goods and lighting goods, Hopnow, which is our line of pouches, backrests, armrests, as well as other convenience related items. Ultra Guard is our full line of bike covers, ranging from the smallest of the scooters all the way to the largest of trikes. Big Bike Parts is located right here in Rice Lake, Wisconsin, again bringing to you many new products for this 2018 Goldwing, as well as the newer models. There are approximately 150 items in our product line that fit this model motorcycle. On the front of the bike, you will see the fog light kits, which are integrated right into the OEM style switch in the dash. You will also see the safety item in the front, which is our cowl light, which functions as a daytime running as well as a turn signal. Big Bike Parts is also well known for its windshields, which still retain the same adjustability as the OEM windshield. Moving back to the back of the bike, we have our smart mount backrest, which quickly installs as well as detaches from the motorcycle, and our full line of pivoting armrests. Comfort-wise, if you look at the bottom of the bike, you have the highway board, the driver board, as well as the passenger inserts. These are going to add style as well as function to your motorcycle. On the back of the bike, you will notice a trunk rack so you can bring additional items with you on your travels. Our UltraGuard line of bike covers comes with a full 5-year warranty. Most of them are going to come with your heat shields, reflective piping, zip-out panels for windshields, sissy bars, where needed and applicable. Underneath this cover is another line of motorcycle, which is the Can-Am Spider. Big Bike Parts is not only known for the Goldwing accessories, but also known for its Can-Am Spider accessories. Again, with 150 products out there for the Goldwing, as well as more on the way, Big Bike Parts is one of the leading designers in this marketplace. WingStuff is also a great dealer of Big Bike Parts, which carries a full line of motorcycle accessories, and make sure to check them out when you're shopping for your motorcycle. Again, brought to you from beautiful Rice Lake, Wisconsin, this is Brandon Westfall from Big Bike Parts, signing out.
Welcome to WingStuff Remote Rally. I'm Harry Eddy, and I'm the inventor of Helibars, and I'd like to welcome you to Heli Modified. We turned 42 years old. I wish I was 42, but 42 years old this year, and I'm going to give you a quick tour of our facility and what we do in here. So let's go out and take a look. Here is our adjustable bar for the 2018 and later Goldwing. It's our adjustable beauty. Over here we have a brand new BMW. It's the 900 XR. Heli Modified has 8,000 square feet of manufacturing And we use a system where we work around in a circle and end up in the center with finished products. And over here, we use an automatic saw, which cuts all our material very accurately. You can see all our material comes in, it's barcoded. Everything's cut here. And when it gets done being machined, it looks like these pieces. Over here are some of the components for our SST handlebars. These are the upper pivot twos. And these pieces here are for the LST handlebar. These are investment cast pieces, which we machine here and powder coat here. These are all SST handlebars going together and LST handlebars. Here's where we do all our assembly. This is how close we are from machine to finished product. Here we're making our investment cast alloy 621 steel clamps. Everything's made in more safety machinery. Just look at how lovely these people keep these work areas. Isn't that something? Yes, beautiful. It's all about efficiency and made in America. Here we have a welding department over in that corner. It's also got a centerless grinder, so that's our dustiest area of the entire shop. Over here are some of the components that we bend in-house. All kinds of bends. And we do this on this beauty over here. It's a five-axis CNC bending mandrel tubing bender. This MV Junior is the first CNC machine that I bought many, many, many years ago. And I can't tell you how many times it's paid for itself. It's an older machine. It's not fully enclosed. You have to be very careful about how you clamp and hold pieces, but it's still worth its weight. It's still worth the real estate it occupies. We've got one automatic fed turning center, which makes all our small components. And over here is our major, major production machine. It's a NH4000, which means it's a horizontal machine. It's very long. It's laid down on its side. Four axis, it has tool touch-off safety protocol. So if a tool breaks, we know about it. And it's got twin stations. We have probably too much fun in this shop. 100% made in America. Just gets better every year. We continually innovate and continue to add new products. Have a great rally. WingStuff carries the full line of Helibar adjustable handlebars and adapters.
Hello everyone, I hope you're having a wonderful day and I hope you're having a chance to get out there and ride with your friends. Like these guys are here behind me. I'm hoping to get out there and join them myself soon. Wanted to tell you a little bit about the new Region X and also discuss the value of Arai and what is it that really makes Arai different from other brands and helmets. When you think of Arai, you're thinking about protection. Protection has been the guiding principle for Arai for 7 decades now. This is a company that has been a family-owned business, handmade, handcrafted helmets in Japan. Arai puts everything they know about protection into every single Arai helmet. And that's one thing that you can always be confident about when you're telling someone about Arai, is that you're giving them the best chance to have the most protection possible out of their helmet. And that's one of the things that just separates Arai from every other helmet manufacturer out there. 70 years of continual ownership by one family. It's a unique thing in any industry. And that's one of the things that helps Arai focus on protection rather than following each new market trend. And so this new helmet here, the new Region X, this is a fantastically comfortable new helmet. It has all the protection, everything you expect from an Arai, and a much more approachable price point. So we're looking at $559 on solids, $689 on graphics. So that's a fantastic price when you're getting the handmade quality that is Arai. So what makes the Region X so much different from all the other previous Arais is the way that they have reshaped the chin bar. The chin bar is now not only 5 millimeters longer here, but it's also 5 millimeters wider throughout this area. So this gives you more space in front of your face. It gives you more room when you try to get in and out of the helmet. It makes that whole process of putting on a helmet for the first time, if maybe you're a new rider and you've never worn a helmet, trying on a helmet can be very intimidating. So having this more open, relaxed system makes it so much easier to put the helmet on and off. So moving on from the chin bar, we have the same chin vent system that you find on most Arais out there. It's a dual position vent. So when you open it to the first position, the air is coming directly to your face through a carbon activated filter. When you go to the second position, now the air is being redirected up towards the shield. I love this vent. You can actually feel that air on your face when you open it. That's one of the things that people are looking for in a helmet, is if it has vents, do they work? And that's something with Arai, you can definitely feel that airflow moving through that vent. Here on the lock for the shield, the first position pushes it up so that you have just a little bit of a gap so you get a little additional airflow. When you want to open the shield the rest of the way, just push up and out and then the shield comes all the way up. When it's time to take the shield off, push back on these levers on each side. That will allow you to bring the brass button to the red dot there and then pull it straight away. So it makes the shield change in operation so much simpler. No pressure there on the side. Everything just feels incredible. It's a fantastic system that's easy to use and makes it so much easier for the end user who may have not been familiar with an Arai system from the past. This makes it much more approachable for them and easy for them to use. Here on the vents, we've got two intake vents. So you just press it, rock it to the rear. That allows the air to come in. Here on the back, we've actually got three exhaust vents. You notice there's no slider to control the vents, so the vents are always open here in the back, but if you don't have the front intake vents open, the exhaust vents aren't going to flow a lot of air, so it's not a big concern in the wintertime when it gets cooler and you might be concerned about it being cold inside the helmet. Once you close those front vents, then that's going to seal off that airflow from moving through the helmet and coming out the back. Looking here at the inside of the helmet, we have a very plush, very comfortable interior. And again, the extra width right here just makes the helmet so much easier to put on, take off. It's so unintimidating for that new rider who may have struggled by putting on other helmets. So the cheek pads have a very soft spring to the material here. So that makes it much easier to put on as well. You're not gonna be folding your ears over like you might in other designs. This makes that entryway just so much more pleasant whenever you're putting on the helmet for the first time. Disassembling the helmet, taking your cheek pads out, very, very simple. You just take your thumb here to the back, get it between the edge of the helmet, pop it out, take it right out. Same thing on the other side, comes right out very simply. Here on the inside, again, sticking with the whole simplified theme of this helmet. In the past, you know, many Arai helmets, you were able to take the multiple layers off. Well, we've simplified it so you don't have the multiple layers that you can take off to adjust the fit. But these cheek pads come in at a very attractive price. They're very inexpensive, so if you have to change the cheek pad size to custom fit, it's not expensive to do. Removing the crown liner, instead of having the snaps like we've had in the past, you've just got two pull tabs here on each side, a Velcro in the center, and then two more Velcros up in the front of the helmet. Again, keeping with the very simplified nature of this, You have a insert that you can remove from the side. If this intermediate oval shape is a little too narrow for you, then you can just take one or both of those inserts out and make it a little bit wider. We are offering 2 to 4 different crown liners for each shell if you need to further customize the fit of the helmet. And the same with the cheek pads, we're still offering 6 different sizes from 12 to 35 millimeters. So if you need to have the helmet just a little tighter on your face, a little looser on your face, there's a wide range of options there to allow you to customize it to be exactly what you want it to be. So that kind of wraps it up for the introduction to the Region X. Remember to check us out on ArayAmericas.com. You can find more information about us there on our website. Also look at our YouTube channel, Arai Helmet Americas on YouTube. You'll see instructional videos. You'll see interviews with our athletes, tours of the factory, and more videos about the value of Arai that you can share with your customers. Thank you guys so much, and ride safe.
Welcome to episode 12 of Rick's Reviews, where I'll share my thoughts and insights on the products that I use and enjoy with all of you. Today, I'll be talking about the Bridgestone tires for the Honda GL1800. Over the last few years, the Bridgestone has continued to be my favorite tire because I was happy with it right out of the gate when I bought my bike. It was the factory tire that came with it, and I've had the opportunity of trying other Goldwings with other brand tires. I still go back to the Bridgestone because there's a lot about that tire that I like. Being on a touring motorcycle like a Goldwing, I really appreciate the Bridgestones because they give you a nice smooth ride and they're not noisy. And on long rides, that can be an issue with certain brands. They tend to be a little noisier. The Bridgestone's very quiet, very smooth tire. I happen to run 40 in the rear and 38 in the front, and that's something that I've done for a lot of years on the Goldwing. It works for me. One of the biggest problems that I see most people have is they're not consistent on checking their tire pressure. They start off that way, but then over time they get lazy. To get the most out of your tires, you need to make sure it's properly inflated and properly balanced. This is going to give you the best handling, the longest tire life, and it's going to reduce the possibility of tire cupping. I've chose to put a TPMS on my bike, which I highly recommend to everybody, like the Fobo. And on the balancing side, I chose the Centramatic wheel balancers because there is no better solution to keep your tires balanced consistently over the life of the tire. I'm averaging about 12 or 13,000 miles on them. And I know some of the other brands you might get a little bit more, but I really like the way this tire handles, and I'm perfectly happy with the miles that it's getting me. I like the soft compound that they use as opposed to other brands. I like that it's sticky. They seem to shed water pretty well. And years ago, I've ridden with tires that were just awful, but overall, I've had no complaints in the rain with the Bridgestone. The Goldwing is a big motorcycle. You're riding 2 up most of the time, there's a lot of weight there, and the tires are super important. And I just think Bridgestone got it right more than anybody else because it works so well for that bike.
Hey, there it goes. Hi guys, Fred Rao here. Welcome to the WingStuff Remote Rally. I want to thank Rick and all the guys over at WingStuff for inviting me to be a part of this. Obviously, it feels kind of weird. I'm sure it does to you too. This time of year, I'd normally be out at the big BMW rally, or of course, the Americade up in New York, or or any number of big Goldwing rallies or BMW rallies, giving seminars about my tours in New Zealand. And obviously I can't do that this year. So Rick came up with this idea of a kind of a virtual rally. So I'm going to treat this like you walked up to me at one of my seminars or at my booth and ask me a bit about what we do. So, and I'll keep it short, okay? So basically, here it is. If you don't know me, I had a long career in motorcycle journalism, editor of Wing World magazine for about 4 years, editor of Road Rider. I was the founding editor and senior editor of Motorcycle Consumer News for about, you know, I don't know, what was it, 18 years or something like that. Anyway, these days, I'm kind of semi-retired and still do some writing, but mostly what I do is what I like to do. At this stage of my life, I'm not going to do something unless I really enjoy it. What I enjoy more than anything else in the world is riding a motorcycle around New Zealand, and particularly taking friends and people that are about to become friends on tours of the islands that I love, that I adore. Rick Arnaldo here, a longtime friend of mine, Rick and I go back about 30 years. It took me 10 years to talk him into going. He went last year, and if you really want to know how much fun it could be, ask Rick. I've never seen anybody have so much fun. Anyway, if you want to see about a 20-minute, 25-minute video about what's included, what's in the tour, what you might see on the tour, what you do on the tour, go to my website. Real easy to remember because it's my name. It's Fred Rau, FredRau.com. That simple. And if you want to email me, ask me any questions about the tours. Again, real easy because it's Fred@FredRau.com. That's it. Okay, couldn't get much easier than that. We definitely, definitely plan on going ahead with our tours for 2021. Although instead of running two tours back to back like I have done previous years, it'll probably just be one tour this year, and that'll be from February the 8th through the 21st of 2021. Now, I know first thing comes to everybody's mind is how much it costs. And that's just a little bit tricky because I don't charge in American dollars. You pay in New Zealand by a bank transfer, a credit card, or check, or whatever you want. But you pay in New Zealand dollars. So when you look at the prices, remember, because that's very important. For example, a two-week deluxe tour for one person runs right around $12,200 New Zealand. And you pay whatever the exchange rate is at that time, at the time you pay. And like if you paid that right now, that $12,200 or so would be right about $7,500 in American money. Okay, so a difference of about $5,000. So you need to keep that in mind. And that includes your motorcycle rental for 2 weeks with taxes and insurance and unlimited mileage. It includes your first class hotel rooms, your breakfast, your dinners, your inter-island ferry between the islands, some extra stuff that we throw in, like a night in Larnach Castle, dinner in the Grand Ballroom, and all that. And a luggage van to carry all your luggage, so it's waiting in your room every night when you get there. Makes it very convenient for you. And a tour guide. And that's me. I'm not some subcontractor that hires other people to run things. I'll be there on the ground, on the bike, with you every day. And I will show you my New Zealand, the New Zealand that I adore. And it is about the most fun you can possibly imagine. So, like I said, you got any questions about it, give me a call, and I'll be glad to answer them. I know with this corona or virus, COVID-19, a lot of worries, people about traveling. I understand that, but this is next February, and I got to believe by next February, it's not going to be a concern. But you might also want to keep in mind, if you haven't seen on the news, New Zealand handled this virus better than I believe any other country did. They shut down early. They put restrictions in place. They wiped it out faster, I believe, than any other country. And it's just a very safe place to go. The people of New Zealand are the nicest you're ever going to want to meet. And I promise to feed you better than you've ever eaten in your life. If you don't come off of my tour 5 pounds heavier than you were when you started, I've done something wrong. It's always a great bunch of people. You make a great bunch of friends. You will ride the most beautiful roads anywhere in the world. You will see the most stunning scenery anywhere in the world. And now, Rick came along with me last year, and I know he's not definitely planning on going again, but I know he wants to go again, which all depends on how many folks I get signed up for the tour. Now, we max out at about 18 people, okay? I never have large tour groups, and we do not travel as one pack, all right? We just don't do that. Every night at dinner, I will give you options of all the different routes you can take the next day, and I'll tell you which way I'm going, and you can follow me, you can go off on your own, you can ride, say tomorrow, I want to ride mountain twisties, real technical. No, I want to take it easy tomorrow. I'll take a nice leisurely ride along the seaside, you know, along the coast. Whatever, it's your tour, your vacation, and believe me, we're going to tailor it so that you get to ride the kind of ride you want to ride. That's the way I do things. Anyway, I promised to keep this short, so I'm going to end it up now. But like I said, go on my website, fredrao.com. It's got my email. Watch the video. You want to email me, you want to call me. My phone number is on there. Call me. Glad to talk to you about it. And I hope I get to see some of you in New Zealand, February the 8th, 2021. And I guarantee the finest ride of your life. Ask anybody that's gone with me, and I've taken about 700 or 800 people to New Zealand. And I don't think I've got a complaint in the group. But anyway, thanks again for coming to the WingStuff Remote Rally. And Rick, thank you for having me. And hope to see you all down the road before too much longer. We need to get out and ride again, don't we? Bye now.
It's Lewis from Electrical Connection, coming to you from somewhat sunny Knoxville, Tennessee for the WingStuff.com virtual trade show. We're going to show you some products that we have on our 2018 Honda Goldwing, and some of these products are available now and some of them are forthcoming. We're really excited to share some of these new products with you. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with the cowl lighting, and then we'll work our way to the back of the bike and show you these other lights. So on the left side of the bike, we have our fog light kit, which is available in two different colors. We do a white and an amber. Amber, if you're looking to make yourself more visible to other on the road. White, if you're looking for just general lighting purposes. We are the only fully adjustable light kit that's available. That way you can get the light center behind the hole. That way you're not taking a light that you paid for and leaving it behind. On this side, we have our new visibility light kit. This will be available in the next week or two. It does not have a lumen rating. All it's designed to do is make you more conspicuous. The beautiful thing about that kit is price point, $99.95 retail. That will include the switch, the wiring, and two lights that mount direct into the cowl. No adjustment is necessary. Again, it's not designed to put light on the robe, just designed to make you more visible. This is our Visibilit 2. This is a aluminum DRL housing, and we wanted to separate the DRL function from fog lights or any other light on the motorcycle. That way, it gets you the most visibility. So it's a white running light, and then an amber turn signal. This is all wired through our distribution system, which I'll show you here in a minute. The roundel lights are coming soon. They are white with an amber turn signal as well. Then our new flexi lights are white with an amber turn signal. The cylinder head top plate lights are white with an amber turn signal. And then we'll walk around to the back of the bike. So we'll start up top with the trunk lights, running light, brake light, both in red. And then when you turn to the turn signal, the red function completely shuts off. That way there's no mixing of the colors. It's very visible one to the other. Our new fender fill lights, they are a flowing turn signal, a running light, and a brake light. The triangle light underneath the license plate is a visibility light. It is a running light and a modulated brake light. The modulating system is built into the light, nothing extra to add. It will pulse three times for five cycles and then go steady. That makes it compliant with the states that have brake light modulation legislation on the books. We also have our LED reflector replacement light. Right now it is a running light. And if you'll notice, one of the things that we've done is we've tried to match the glow of the OEM tail lights. That way it just has more of a flowing look to the whole setup. On the inside of the trunk, we have our cubbies, which are dividers that give you a clean and easy way to have separated storage for small items. We also have the mesh pouch here, so you can keep your little documents handy. There are what we call the cupsters on the inside, and that gives you a place where you can hold a ink pen, a tire gauge, anything small that you don't want roaming around in the rest of the trunk. The trunk lights, by the way, will work on the OEM Honda trunk lid and the Corbin extended trunk lid, as you see here. This is a product that we just released this week. It is a fob protector. It is CNC machined aluminum. It protects the fob from getting all nicked up. Great thing is the way this is machined out, you have accessibility for your emergency key so you don't have to take it apart. You have access to all three buttons on the back, and also visible is the LED function indicator. The belt loop is included, and it has a little latch so that you can just hook it on your belt. Now we're going to talk about our light distribution system. All of these new lights that I showed you, with the exception of the fog lights and the front cowl visibility light kit, all utilize our new proprietary micro connector. These are waterproof, and every light that we build has this connector on it. So our light distribution system, the way we have this set up, since a lot of people already have a trailer isolator, we use that isolator because it's usually never used to capacity. So the isolator takes the triggers from the motorcycle, feeds it out to the distribution block, and then everything that's hooked up to this motorcycle, right now I believe we are at 16 lights, is hooked up through this module. So this is our distribution flower, four heads. Come with with dust caps to keep everything clean and waterproof. When you go to install a product, you will mount the light. You will have this connected to your distribution block. There's a harness that will interconnect between the two. That's it, you're done. Now let's say you've added our distribution system, but you want to add a light from one of our competitors, Goldstrike, SoCal Moto Gear, or Kuryakyn. We've got you covered. These are adapters that will plug into our harness and feed whatever brand of light you happen to purchase. This would be for a Goldstrike lighting product. This is the Kuryakyn, and this is the SoCal Moto Gear. One thing to note, even though these two manufacturers are using the same connector, they are not pinned out the same way. You cannot use these. They're not interchangeable one brand to the other. You have to get the brand specific to the one that you're installing. So again, take this, plug it in, and you can plug in your whatever light you want. So I'll do a quick run around of the distribution block. So if you have our trailer isolator or you have a show chrome distribution system, you can utilize this to expand everything. These are your inputs: left turn, right turn, tail light, brake light, and dual grounds. And the reason we have two grounds, each of these circuits is capable of 10 amps. This splitter takes one in, creates two outputs. That way you have your ground loop, ground lugs here, ground lugs there. Left turn, right turn, brake light, and tail light. Each of these can be multiple wires in each slot, so it's very expandable. And then there is a cover for it to protect it against dust and water. That's included in the kits. So the distribution system will be available as well as all these lighting products in the next 4 weeks. We're very excited about this. It's something we've been working on for quite a while. We do have a few other items that are on this bike that I'll be happy to show you. These are kind of old standards that we've been building for quite a while. This is our master ground block. So all the grounds in this motorcycle are connected to this block. There is a 10 gauge high strand count cable that comes off that. I actually have it grounded to the bolt right here for the top battery bar holder. That way there's nothing else additional that is connected to the battery. Give me an idea about how clean this is. That's it. Nothing on it except the OEM connector. We do have our power plate, fuse plate. It mounts right here. And the reason we put it here, if you have a blown fuse, you don't want to have to be taking the seat off to access the fuse. So the relay that controls it is underneath the seat because you don't need to access it really once it's installed. You just need to be able to get at that. Six outputs, they accept ATC, mini ATC, or micro ATC fuses. So if you're on the road, you blow a fuse, you can get any of those three and it will work in that device. Rated up to 30 amps. This bike also has our new DCT interlock harness. So if you have the DCT model and you've ridden off with the parking brake on, you solved that problem. So it interconnects through the side stand circuit. Bike will not go into gear. You see the side stands up. You release the parking brake. Now we're in gear. Up here we have our new top perch, and it's multi-function. It will allow you to add our proprietary cup holder. I'm not a big fan of having a bunch of things in the cockpit, so I wanted something that was simple. The great thing about this is you can actually use this to mount a GoPro. You can use it for our cup holder. When it's on and the safety is engaged, you cannot take this off. The safety has to be removed in order for that to come off. That way you're not going to lose your cup holder or your GoPro. It's also drilled and tapped on the inside for a 6mm ram bolt. So if you wanted to add another item here like a cell phone mount or a GPS radar detector, we can do that. We have this available for both the DCT, which would be the brake side. We also have one for the left side for the six-speed manual. We also have just finished up the first production batch of a cover for the pre-18 goldwing that has 3 points of mounting, 6mm ram ball on each side, and then a 5/16 on the top. So you can add a cup holder, 2 rams, you could do 3 ram balls. It just gives you all kinds of different options. The last thing I'll mention is if you're going to be adding Muth mirrors, we will have an adapter that will go into our distribution system to make the wiring as simple as possible. And for those of you who don't know why we do the distribution system, this bike is all computer controlled. There are, on the DCT, there are 10 computers on this bike. The OEM wiring, we have no idea what the capacity of it is. It's all driven by chipsets in the control modules, and rather than risk damage, we isolate them, and everything on this bike is powered separate. It takes triggers from the bike, but everything is powered essentially directly from the battery. That way, if you have a failure, you don't cause any damage to the motorcycle, whether it be a taillight, a control module, a switch housing, the fuse blows, you fix the problem, you put a new fuse in, you're done. That way you're covered when it comes to warranty. Honda can't deny a warranty claim if you wire things up the right way. So I think that's about it. We've got more stuff coming, but this is what's available now and coming in the interim. We thank you for watching and hope you enjoyed what we had to show you today, and enjoy the rest of the rally.
This is Greg with Two Brothers Racing, and welcome to WingStuff's Remote Rally. Two Brothers Racing was founded in 1985 in beautiful Southern California, and is still proudly made in the USA today. We offer everything from goldwing exhaust to sport bikes and Harleys. But speaking of goldwing exhaust, let's take a look inside and see how everything's made. WingStuff carries our complete line of exhausts, including our brand new 2018 through 20 system we just launched. We'll see you on the road.
everybody, Kyle here from Add-On Accessories here in Worcester, Massachusetts, and welcome to the WingStuff Remote Rally 2020. Today we're going to take you downstairs to our main warehouse to demonstrate some of the new products for the 2018 plus Honda Goldwing, as well as some parts for the older Goldwings. All the parts you will see listed here today will be at www.wingstuff.com, or you can refer to our direct website at www.addonaccessories.net. Now we're going to take you downstairs to our technician Al, who has been servicing your needs for 20 plus years in the Goldwing industry. Let's go.
What we're going to look at today is 45-1233C windscreen strut covers. Extremely easy to install. They're a direct replacement for the black OEM parts. Takes about 10 minutes to change them. All you do is pull the reusable snap out of the back of the OEM black cover. Remove the black cover, put the chrome cover on, put your snap back in, and the job is done. About 10 minutes, and they're even marked on the back left and right to make it even easier. Second part, 45-1623C, saddlebag guard covers. Chrome covers to replace the black OEM plastic covers. Again, about a 10-minute job. Pull the reusable snap out of the black cover on the bottom. Pop it out. Black cover comes off. Chrome cover goes on. Snap goes back in. Again, about a 10-minute job. Unless you're an old guy like me, then you had 10 minutes to get up off the floor. All right, next part, 45-1622C, engine guard covers. Again, it's to replace the black OEM plastic covers. These covers take a little bit longer to put on the engine guards because you need to remove the right and the left lower cowls. You pull the cowls off on the back, you will see that the black covers are held in with a pin. You pull the pins out, take the black cover off, put the chrome on, put the pins back, reinstall the lower cowl. Job is done again. Gotta give it about 30 to 45 minutes, and another 30 to 45 minutes for old guys like me to get up off the floor. Next part, 45-1824, center taillight trim. It's a brake and running light. You simply unsnap the black trim on your bike, which is located at the bottom of the touring trunk. You snap in our light. It's a brake and running LED light. It is not plug and play. You need to tap into the bike's wiring harness. Ground, running light, and brake light. Comes on when your lights are on. When you hit the brakes, it doubles in intensity. Again, it's LED. The next part are our new, we don't even have them in stock yet. These are the prototypes. It is the front turn signal and daytime running light. It's a direct replacement for the OEM part, plug and play. The OEM light, you'll see that it's held in the mirror housing with three screws. Remove the three screws, pop the OEM light out, unplug it, take our light, plug it in. Drops in the housing, three screws installed. That's what it'll look like in the bike. And in just a second, you're gonna see these lights on the bike at the factory in operation. Again, it's a white LED daytime running light with amber sequential turn signals built in. And it is plug and play. Plugs right into the bike's wiring harness. You gotta give yourself about an hour on these because you have to pull the mirror housings apart. Put them back in, done deal.
Thank you.
All right, guys, Kyle Libeszewski back here. We thank you for attending the WingStuff 2020 Virtual Remote Rally. Once again, if you have any question on any of these products you have seen in this video, please refer to www.wingstuff.com or by reaching out to us directly at www.addonaccessories.net. You can also call us at 508-791-7552 for any more direct information on these products. Signing off here from Worcester, Massachusetts, we hope you safe and happy riding.
Hi folks, I'm Don Frank with F4 Customs. Before we get started with the virtual rally, I'd like to say a special thanks to all the folks at WingStuff. Rick has a tremendous organization. We appreciate all that he does. What I've done is I've set up a small booth here, and it's not like we normally have at a rally where we have tremendous amount of products set out for you to see, but I think it'll really show you what we're all about. So let's just act like somebody walked up to our booth and said, why would I buy an F4 Customs windshield? What makes them different? Well, you know, we love it when people ask that question. So here's the difference. F4 Customs makes their windshield out of high optics polycarbonate, the best high optics polycarbonate we can buy. Then we bake our own coatings into it. It's a proprietary coating that is baked in both sides, and that coating makes the windshield extremely tough. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, here's a windshield wrapped with steel wool. And if you've attended any of the rallies where we've been at, you've seen this windshield wiper going back and forth. And what we've done is we've got a stock windshield or stock material on this side. And then we have our baked-in coating on this side. What you can see here is this side is all scratched up. Steel wool is just, you know, eating into the coating. On this side, not the case. The steel wool just glides across the top of it. And so it's the baked-in coating that makes the difference. Now, what that means is that for cleaning our windshields, you clean them with paper towels and any glass cleaner you want to use. They're chemically sealed, so it doesn't matter what glass cleaner you use. We like the F4 cleaner because the F4 cleaner doesn't streak, but you can use any one you want to. Even the gas station paper towels are fine. Why paper towels? Steel wool won't scratch it. Paper towels don't have a chance, and they're clean every time. So let's talk about optical clarity. When you go into the twisties and that sort of thing, it's important because you may be looking over the windshield as you look out at a distance, but as you go into the twisties, you're looking through. It's very important that there's no optical distortion whatsoever. So they're optically perfect. They clean with paper towels. They won't scratch with steel wool. And when you get into the rain will fly off just like Rain-X on steroids. They're extremely good in the rain. Now, what windshields do we handle for the Goldwing? For the Goldwing, we offer the 1200 model, 1500 model, 1800 up to 2017, and then the 2018 and newer. Now, on the 1200, let's start there. We offer a 1200 stock replacement in clear, and a plus 4 in clear. It's 4 inches taller than stock. So that windshield, the plus 4, really gets the air up and over. Now that windshield is a special order. Takes about 2 to 3 weeks to get it. On the 1500, we offer a stock height. We offer a plus 2 and a plus 4. So it's a stock replacement, 2 inches taller than stock, and 4 inches taller than stock. The 4-inch is not adjustable. The stock and plus 2 are. Now you can get those in clear and in tint. You can get them with or without a vent. We use a Honda 1800 Goldwing vent tinted because they really hold up well. So we use those in the 1500s as well. So on the 2018, we offer a sport windshield. Now that's 2 inches shorter than stock. And I might add, our windshield keeps the same angle as the stock windshield. So if you like the sporty look, you know, you want a little bit more airflow, that really works well to buy a sport. Then we have the stock replacement. And then we have one 2 inches taller in stock and about a half inch wider per side. Now, all three of those are fully adjustable. So you can use your vent in those too if you have a vent already. All you have to do is order a windshield with the vent hole, and then you can take your vent out and put it in there. Those are offered again in clear, light tint, with or without a vent. Then we have the Plus 4. The Plus 4 has been our biggest seller, and the Plus 4 comes in clear tint, with or without a vent. You do have to buy our vent on that one because the windshield's thicker. But that's for the Plus 4 is for the rider and co-rider that are wanting the best ride. They want the best air management. That puts the air up and over both of them, really greatly reducing the head buffeting and the microphone noise. So for two-up riding, it's highly recommended. So now let's talk about the new 2018 and newer. And I happen to have those up here on display. So the Goldwing itself came with a 16-inch. The Goldwing Tour came with a 20-inch. And this is a 24. So the Goldwing, standard Goldwing with a 16-inch comes with a straight windshield. What we offer here is a 16, 20, and 24. The 16 and 20 have a recurve. Now I'm going to take this windshield out and I'm going to hold it over to the side. So hopefully you can see the recurve that's on this windshield. Now what does that recurve do? That recurve moves the air up an additional 2 inches. So again, you can see the recurve. So if you're riding with a 20-inch stock windshield and you want more air to move up higher, but you don't want to go higher with a windshield, this recurve is a really nice option. And by the way, folks, no distortion through the recurve at all. Now, we also made them wider. You can order a stock width from F4, but on your stock width, on your stock Hondo windshield for the 2018, those windshields are cut in at the top. They're tapered in. With us, even our stock width, we kept them out a little bit, get that air out around more. But then we found it was really necessary to add about an inch and a half, 2 inches on the outside here. And what that does is move the air out and around. It really does a nice job. So we call this our wide series. So this particular windshield is a 20-inch clear wide. Now for the riders that are riding two up and say that, you know what, we like to look through the windshield. We want the best possible airflow we can get. Well, that's the 24-inch. The 24-inch windshield is a very, very nice windshield. It's wide. It doesn't come in standard width. And it's 24 inches tall. So you're riding with a 20-inch. This is 24, so it's 4 inches taller. So it'll move the air up 2 inches further than the 20-inch recurve. So this one does not have a recurve. This is just a standard straight windshield. So that's what we offer for the 2018. So with F4 Customs, when you buy a windshield, you're buying a windshield that's going to last. We're a family-owned organization. When you call F4, you'll speak to myself or my wife, Kim, and we'll try to answer any questions that you have, and we'll give you the personal service that you deserve. So again, thanks to Rick at WingStuff. Thanks, folks, for listening about the F4 Customs windshield, and ride safe.
Hi guys, this is David Cook, brand manager for UClear Digital USA, coming to you from my home in beautiful Boise, Idaho, to the remote rally brought to you by WingStuff.com. For the next few minutes, we're going to review the UClear product lineup of helmet audio and accessories that work excellently with Goldwing products, especially your 2018 and above that are just set and ready to go to work with helmet comms with their Bluetooth setup. WingStuff.com's got the best selection, and they've got people that know what they're talking about with helmet audio. So for the next few minutes, we're going to discuss the UClear lineup, what sets us apart, and why you should be checking out the UClear products at WingStuff.com.
As you probably noticed, guys, I have a face for radio, so I'm going to narrate the next few minutes, starting with some information for you about Bluetooth comm systems in general. Bluetooth comm systems from the major companies in the category, it's just Sina, Cardo, and UClear, are going to have four main things or features in common, and that's going to be that they can handle phone calls, music, intercom, and provide some level of noise cancellation for power sports that you don't get with standard Bluetooth headsets you might use with your phone. Okay, the difference between this is going to be the quality with which we handle each one of these things. Now, we at UClear feel that we're second to none in our music quality, our intercom capability, and the type of noise cancellation that we offer. We do provide premium speakers with every price point and graphic equalizer. Our intercom is based on Bluetooth 5 DynaMesh. That's that good intercom, guys, that allows you to change your riding positions as a group and not be disconnected. If someone leaves the group and rejoins, they're going to be automatically reconnected. It's just constantly searching for a way to keep you connected. The noise cancellation side of things, UClear has a patent on a dual microphone technology that lets us sample from the left side and the right side simultaneously and combine them into one powerful noise cancellation to get rid of that wind noise and that road noise when you're talking to your fellow riders. But what really sets us apart, what we're really proud of at UClear, is what we invented in the late 2019, which is the USAFE Rider Crash Detection and Contact Alerts. You're going to see that listed as a feature for the UClear Motion Infinity. But guys, that's an accelerometer that knows when you've had a crash or an impact, and it can save your life. It can send out your GPS coordinates, custom messages, list of nearby hospitals to three emergency contacts 30 seconds after you crash if you're unconscious or unable to disable it. If your Goldwing was built prior to 2018, you've got some options on how to use comm systems with your bike. You can use the UClear, for example, for the music intercom and calls separate from the Goldwing system, and then use the Goldwing system and speakers for CB and FM radio. Another solution available to you is a tethered corded solution made by J&M Audio and available through WingStuff.com. The J&M solution would be fully integrated into your bike via a tethered cord. Another great solution available to you would be to install the Blue Hub made by J&M Audio and available at WingStuff.com and pair your UClear to it. The Blue Hub hardwires into your Goldwing for full integration into its systems, but then provides a wireless Bluetooth access point to which the UClear can pair. So once you've installed the Blue Hub and paired your UClear to it, you have the best of both worlds, meaning full integration into the bike systems without having a wire tethering your helmet down to the bike. If your Goldwing was manufactured in 2018 or later, it's already got Bluetooth headset support built into it. That means that UClear can pair to it directly with full integration without any additional wires or extra parts to install. Basically, how that works is you're going to pair your smartphone to the Goldwing as your audio source. Next, you're going to Bluetooth pair your UClears to the Goldwing as headset one and headset two for the passenger. Then all you have to do is change the Goldwing's audio output from the integrated speakers to headset and then turn up the volume. You're done and you're ready to go ride. Now that we know that UClear Helmet Audio integrates very well with Goldwing, let's take a look at a few of the UClear models that will be available to you at WingStuff.com, starting with the Amp Go 2 with a retail of only $119.95. At that price point, you're getting the newest Bluetooth 5 chips, two rider intercom, premium speakers, adjustable noise cancellation, and graphic equalizer for those. These little guys are weatherproof, they're ruggedized, they come with universal pairing, so you can not only pair them to the Goldwing, but you could pair them to a GPS unit. You can even pair them with other brand comm systems. ClearLink mobile app is included with this. That's where you're going to set up your user preferences and configuration You've got access to tech support and the user manual in there, as well as wireless firmware updates, so you don't have to plug these into a computer to keep them updated. These are super easy to install. It takes a person an average of 5 minutes start to finish with the AmpGo, and they're just really nice and easy to operate as well. Now on to the new Motion series from UClear. You're looking at Motion 4 here. That's a four-rider DynaMesh intercom, and you're picking up voice commands and voice prompts. The rest of the features are going to be the same things that we went over with AmpGo. Stepping up to the Motion 6, you now have six-rider DynaMesh intercom, and you're picking up that really cool buttonless laser gesture sensor that UClear invented. Guys, that's an actual laser beam that comes out the bottom of the UClear unit. It allows you to control things like pause and restart music, music track, volume, by just simply tapping the unit with your hand with an open palm. So if you have heavy gloves on, you don't like using voice commands, you don't want to fiddle with buttons, the laser gesture sensor is very quick and very easy to use. And with a little bit of practice, you'll have it down really quickly. I personally use it all the time, and I really like it. Our flagship model, and the one that I personally ride with, is the Motion Infinity. With Motion Infinity, you retain all those features that we've already talked about. What you're really picking up here is Infinite Rider DynaMesh Intercom and that USafe Rider Crash Detection System. If you are out there riding around by yourself, if you're commuting, or if you're out there with a passenger but not with a group, the Rider Crash Detection System is peace of mind, and it really works. We've saved a lot of people already with this, and I love it. It's one of the things I'm the most proud of at UClear. These UClear units are pretty darn simple to install, and they'll fit in just about any helmet on the market. These are the three main components of your UClear install: a mount that simply goes on with premium 3M adhesive, your controller, and your speakers. You get all three of those put into your helmet and you are ready to go. We have a good time building UClear products and helping customers to use them. I think it's safe to say that we're riders first and UClear employees second, but because we love to ride and really appreciate our own products, we like helping customers. That means that once you've already got a UClear, we hope that you'll give us a call, tell us the good, the bad, and the ugly, let us help you out with anything, and we think that WingStuff.com has that same kind of staff. They're enthusiasts. They like what they do, they're knowledgeable, and they're there for you. So we're hoping that you will further check in to UClear and that you'll do it at wingstuff.com. Thanks for your time and enjoy the ride.
Kisan Electronics, and want to welcome you guys to the WingStuff Remote Rally. I'd like to thank Rick and the team over at WingStuff for putting this together. It's an innovative idea, just like everything they do. They do it big and bold, and they're always innovating. Anyways, a little bit about Kisan. For those, there are many of you who probably know us. I mean, we've been attached to the Winger community from the start, really. And we've made products for every generation of wing out there. But let me tell you more about how the company got started. It started with two electrical engineers in college who actually, when they graduated, were hired by Honda in Japan to go over and develop the first tire pressure monitoring system for their F1 cars. They did that successfully, and I'm not sure how long, I think maybe 2 years later, they came back to America and in California started Kisan Electronics. Reason being is they're both avid motorcyclists, electronic engineers, and they wanted to bring safety to an industry that they felt needed it. And here we are 30-something, 40-something years later with Kisan. What do they make for your bike? Well, they have two basic items. They have what they call the path blazer and the tail blazer. The path blazer is for the front of your bike. Tail blazer, take a wild guess, maybe the back. Definitely the back. But anyways, the path blazer is your first item, and that is basically a headlight modulator. It's designed to flash your headlight in daylight with the aid of a light sensor, and only works when your high beams are on. So it gives you the ability to turn it on when you need it and leave it off when you don't. There are plenty of people who install it and use it almost never, but in the time when they need something to just give them a little extra visibility for oncoming traffic, they can flip their high beam on and add that extra flash to make them safer while they ride. Allows them to enjoy the ride and know they have a little insurance when needed. The other item they carry is the tail blazer. It also modulates. It winks in a decelerating pattern and then going solid when you hit the brakes. The idea being is keep people from driving up your tailpipe. Other people you're riding with, or the cagers out there that are just texting on their phone and not really paying attention. I think this is a critical component for every motorcyclist, and I'd like to evangelize to the whole motorcycle community that you should consider something like this, because your safety is important, naturally. My safety when I'm out there, I don't ride without them. They're absolutely fantastic. Some things to think about. There are, actually, let's go back a little bit. Path blazer. The path blazer, there are a couple key questions. One being, does it work with conventional and LED bulbs? Yes. The great news is you can reprogram any path blazer for any motorcycle to work with either by simply flipping a few switches on your handlebar control. That easy. The patterns are slightly different. They're designed to work with the type of bulb you're using. If it's a conventional bulb, the flash pattern is a little different than it would be for LED. Now, that leads me to the next question is, will this reduce the life of my bulbs? Absolutely not. If anything, it will make them last longer, because it keeps the thermal shock down. It's basically pulse width modulation on a larger scale. They're CAN bus compatible, and Kisan has them for every generation of Wing. I think I already said that, but I say it again. And hundreds of other bikes. Oh, and also the F6B, of course. Is it legal? Absolutely. In all of North America, you have the ability to ride on any road. It is federally mandated, and we've designed the flash pattern to work within that. So if someone stops you and they say, hey, listen, those aren't legal, they're absolutely incorrect. You can find some information on that in the handy instruction booklet that's very detailed, that'll help you install it on your motorcycle. I think that about covers the path blazer. Maybe a little bit more on the tail blazer. Keep in mind that it's a decelerating pattern or a decaying pattern. So when you first grab the brake, it's gonna go flash, 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 and then solid. That way it doesn't become annoying to the person in front of you. It just wakes them up a little bit. Anyways, I could blabber on all day about all this stuff. I wanted to thank Rick and the gang over at WingStuff. The rally is a fantastic idea. Stay safe out there. Contact WingStuff for more information. They have all the data, and if they don't have it, they'll put you in touch with us. We'll help get you all figured out so that you can ride safe and enjoy life. Be well.
I'm Dan Matthew. I'm the Director of Aftermarket Products here at Muth Mirrors Systems, and we are happy to be a part of the WingStuff Remote Rally, and we would like to welcome you to Sheboygan, Wisconsin. We are super pumped about our new goldwing signal mirrors for the new goldwing. They fit the new model year, and Rick's video has really spurred sales of these, so you better get yours soon. So come on, I'll give you a little walk through here, all right? Denise is doing the video. Watch your step, Denise. Reception area. We don't have a lot of people that are excited about being in this video. A little reclusive here in Wisconsin, but some people are willing. So this is our purchasing department. There's Martin in there.
Hey, Mondo.
That's what they sometimes call me around here, is Mondo. So, this is our production area. I can't really take you down there because we got some secret stuff going on down there that we can't show you. This is our, I can't show you our wall of fame. This is all the customers that we do a lot of business with. We have been doing LED mirrors for 28 years, and I've been here for 26 of those. So I've been right involved with a lot of the innovations that have been going on in LEDs, and it's been really exciting. Muth itself has been around for 47 years. It's a family-owned company, or at least it has been. It's a fixture here in Sheboygan, so we're happy to be working here, and we're happy to be serving you. This is our engineering department over here. I can't take you in there because they're secretive too. But I can take you over to our recreation area. This is, you see over here, our ping pong tables. Our CEO, Ken Muth, is literally the best ping pong player that you're ever gonna meet. So don't challenge him if you ever come to visit. Yeah, well, let's just take the rest of the tour. We have a weight room here. This is a nice feature for our employees. It's where we can build up our muscles to get strong enough to build those signal mirrors. Okay. So this is a nice little facility we have here. And then this is our yoga room. This is where we add the most important part to our signal mirrors. Come on in. Here they get their, they get drained of all bad vibes, and we add some nice, good spirit of the road to them. This is Pete. He's our lead prototype technician. Pete, make sure you add some good juice to this one. Thank you very much. Thanks for walking through with us at Muth Mirror Systems. Make sure you buy something from Uncle Rick at WingStuff. He's a great egg. God bless from all of us here in Sheboygan.
Welcome to the WingStuff Remote Rally. I'm Nate with Gmax, and thanks for stopping by. Got a couple helmets to show you guys today. First one is this modular. This is our MD-01. It is an ECE DOT helmet, metal, all the way 360 metal connects on that. Drop down sun shield. You'll notice that lever is set back. We did that so you can still put that comm system there on the side of the helmet. Also built in speaker pockets for the comm system as well. Our nice integrated LED light comes stock with the helmet. Three modes, solid on, strobing, back and forth, and then my favorite is that Knight Rider. One more, you're all the way off. You can upgrade that piece. This right here is the LED brake light kit. So then it links remotely to your bike. When you hit the brake, the light on the helmet comes on. It's all wireless, and that's $39.95. The helmet itself starts out at $199.95. Moving into our open face, this is our GM32. This one starts out at $74.95. Peak visor and the drop down sun shield. You also have an open close front vent and rear. Nice thing is this peak visor is removable. Snaps right off. And included, you'll see the fourth and fifth snaps, so you can add on aftermarket shields and visors as well. Then moving to our next one, let me set this here. This is my favorite open face that we have here at Gmax. The reason why is it's very upgradable and you can really customize this helmet to what you need. Starts out at $99.95. Shield, drop down sun shield in there as well. Has a nicer interior, which is our Spa Soft, which is antimicrobial, and it is moisture wicking. Now you'll notice back here the similarities to the MD-01, where it sees, looks like it has that light back there. It doesn't come stock with it, but it is upgradable. So you can get the LED brake light, $39.95, add that to it. Or you can just do the LED light, which is like the one in the MD-01, you're at $17.95. More to upgrade, let me grab this helmet here, swap it out. And you'll notice is this snap-in jaw. So this jaw piece is really easy, snap-in, snap-out. $14.95 for those jaw. So you can really customize this helmet and make it for what you want. Again, starts at $99.95. These helmets and everything you've seen here are available at wingstuff.com along with the full line of Gmax helmets. Thanks again for stopping by and enjoy the rally.
Welcome to the WingStuff Remote Rally. I'm Tim with Kuryakyn, and we've got some new product to show you on the 18 and later Goldwing. Let's start right away on the front end with our windshield trim. Covers up the stock hardware in a nice chrome, easy to install. Underneath that is a little bit of a hidden part, but it is our tie down that can be used when trailering or working on your bike on a lift. It's a great, simple way to secure your bike. So we move around to the side. Want to take note of the front fork LED light. It is a switch black light, white as a running light, amber as a turn signal, and goes back to white as a running light. Behind that, we have our air deflectors, both upper and lower, two separate pieces, independently adjustable for keeping the cool wind off you on the fall and winter days. Also opens up and can direct air back to you on those hotter summer days. Next to that, we've got our Omni collection for grips and levers, available in chrome or satin black, and our drink holder that mounts right securely to the clutch perch. As we move down, let's take a look at our highway pegs with the mount, arm, and foot peg, again in the Omni collection. It has three different mounting positions for adjustability, as well as adjustable angle that we've got on the peg mount here. Behind that, we've got our Omni driver floorboard kit, complete with heel toe shifter. And the heel shifter is a little bit different than we've had in the past. It's not quite as long, giving you full use of the floorboard with your feet. Behind that, we've got our passenger floorboards that have an alternate foot position for the passenger, giving them added comfort. As we move back a little bit, you can see that we've also got an Omni light for our saddlebag. It is red as a running light, and forgive me as I step in front here, but it turns amber and switches to amber as a turn signal, making it clear what your intentions are when you're riding. On the seat, we've got the driver backrest kit, which is easily removable. It is adjustable both up and down. And the nice thing that I like about this is when you have a passenger, it just folds right over, giving you ease of access to the rear. Behind that, we've got our passenger armrests. They simply flip forward, giving the added comfort, and they stow right out of the way for when you're getting on and off the bike, making that easy. As you come around to the rear of the bike, one of the biggest pieces that you'll notice is our luggage rack. It is nice and wide, flat, super easy for securing things. Then as you look at the back end, you will notice a lot of lighting, which we're really, really proud of. Coming soon, and this is a sneak peek, is our trunk light, as well as our license plate mount light. These you'll see shortly. They are red as a run. Let me go ahead and hit the brakes for you, and you can notice the added visibility when you hit the brake. They also function as a turn signal. And again, we've got the switch back to amber as a turn signal in all of the lights. Not to be forgotten, trailer hitch and wiring harness that we offer as well. One other part that is hidden is our trunk organizer. As with previous Goldwing models, it mechanically attaches to the lid and gives you the place to store those things like sunscreen, sunglasses, night driving glasses, and the little things that you want to be able to get to quickly. I'd like to thank you for taking the time as we walked around our Goldwing, and we're going to do a quick all around bike shot, and I've got one more thing to tell you. Here at Kuryakyn, we're super excited about the new products for the 18 and later Goldwing, and they are all available at wingstuff.com.
Hi, my name is Rodney. I'm with Keystone Distributing. We are the U.S. distributor of Centramatic Wheel Balancers Motorcycle Division, and I'm here at WingStuff's Remote Rally to show you folks what this product will do for you. This is a dynamic wheel balancing system that once installed on your bike will balance your wheels and tires forever. This will result in 30 to 50% better tire wear, longer life, dampens vibration. This thing does it all. As far as balancing your wheels, you put them on and forget about it. Tire changes, no more weights, forever. So I've got a brief demonstration I want to go with to show you kind of what it does. I'm going to step on this side. This is a wheel that's going to represent the tire on your motorcycle. I'm going to just turn it on real quick. Now, this is just the tire without any balancing whatsoever. It's okay. It's pretty smooth. Not too bad. What we're going to do is introduce a slight imbalance represented by this weight. So we're going to install this on the wheel. And then we're going to turn it on again, and you'll see what an unbalanced wheel will look like. As you can see, this thing is all over the place, vibrations. It looks like it's going to fly off. We're going to turn it off. This little demonstration uses this item, which is basically a plastic ring filled with oil and bearings to represent the Centramatic wheel balancers. That's basically what's going on inside. We're going to install the balancer, just like you would on your motorcycle. And then we're going to turn it on again, and you're going to notice the difference right away. Once this thing spins up to speed, you will notice that it will balance the wheel. There we go. So once we get up to speed, you'll notice that it's now smooth again. You can't really see it right now, but if you were here, you'd be able to see all the bearings on this side of the on the opposite side of where the imbalance is. Again, now it's all smoothed out. As you can see, the wheel weight, the imbalance is still there. The only thing we've added was that ring. That's how Centramatics works. Basically, constantly, consistently balancing your wheels for the life of your motorcycle. So once again, I'm here at the WingStuff Remote Rally. Be sure to go to WingStuff's website and check out all the videos and reviews. Once again, we have a 30-day guarantee, a 5-year unlimited mile warranty. This is about as close to a no-brainer as you're going to find. Please come check us out, and thank you for your time.
From Utopia Products, and we're here at the WingStuff Virtual Rally because, you know, we can't get together this year. Hope everybody's doing fine with this COVID virus going around. But anyway, there's our sign, Utopia Products. We've made these backrests for many, many years. We started our business in 74, my husband and I, and we made custom motorcycle seats at that time until 1985, and then we started making the backrest. And we've been doing it ever since. And we had to stop making the custom seats because the backrest kind of like took over. And we've had our family. It's just a family operation, made in USA, made here in Ohio. And it started with my mom and dad. We had them work for us. My son, my daughter, my son-in-law, my daughter-in-law, my sister, my brother-in-law. I mean, you name it, our family has been in our business and still are in our business. We're here at the rally, and I don't know, it looks like we've only got two left, but I tell you, WingStuff will have them for you. They always have them on stock. They carry them for the older 1800s, the newer 1800s. They all come with a pouch on the back, and I believe they even carry them for the F6Bs. I really appreciate you stopping by our booth. I know we'll sell out soon, so be sure to call WingStuff. I'm sure they'll have them for you. Thanks a lot for stopping by, and God bless.
I'm Paul Gomez, Sales and Marketing Manager for National Cycle, and we're very, very happy to be here at the virtual rally supporting our great partner, WingStuff.com. WingStuff.com is your go-to source for all the National Cycle GL 1800 and 1500 accessories and windshields. So go to WingStuff.com and get everything you need. National Cycle has been influencing and setting the standard at both OEM and aftermarket level for over 8 decades. Ultimately, coming up with a hard-coated polycarbonate, which is 3-year warranty against breakage. Quantum hard coating set the standard for resistance against abrasion. RainZip, this is your answer to RainX, which does not play well with plastics, and also available as an innovation of National Cycle. For your GL 1800 latest version, we offer both standard V-Stream models as well as this new V-Stream Deluxe, which includes mounting hardware brackets that allow it to mount correctly to your GL 1800 while maintaining all the functionality of your stock windshield. In concert with that, we've included wind deflectors, which are available separately. However, enhance and increase and offer the maximum of wind deflection to add many, many miles of riding comfort. While you're at WingStuff.com, don't forget to check out our comfort bars. They're available in an E-coated powder black, as well as stainless steel electro polish. They do come, or I should say, we offer brackets that will allow you to mount any standard aftermarket foot peg to enhance your riding comfort. Again, when it comes to riding comfort, look for National Cycle at WingStuff.com.
I'm Dave with Ultimate Seats, and I'm really excited to be here at the WingStuff Remote Rally. Today I'm going to talk to you about our offerings for the 2018 and newer Goldwing and Goldwing Tour. The three things I'm going to talk to you about today are the seat, the driver backrest, and the passenger backrest. First, the seat. We build on a strong base, so we have a strong foundation for the seat. It's a fiberglass reinforced urethane. And then on top of that, we have our foam. Now our foam is a memory foam, which is different than anybody else uses. And what that means is that the foam remembers the shape that we mold it into. Every single seat that we offer has its own individual mold. So we mold it into that shape, and that's the shape that it remembers. So it acts like a suspension system whenever you're sitting on it. Now, as far as our engineering philosophy, it's the same as we do with all of our seats. We do a nose-up angle, and we cup them out side to side, both in the driver section and the passenger section. Now in the driver section, we also have a feature, which is called our expansion joint. This seam here, especially on the sock seat, is seamed right here. Now we actually do an expanding joint, so this part of the seat drops down and you don't get that pressure across your tailbone. The next thing we're going to talk about is the driver backrest. The nice thing about that is it does fold down out of the way for mounting the bike. So you fold that down, put your leg over, and sit down. It also has 2 inches of adjustment that can be adjusted on the fly. You just run this thumb screw here, forward and back, no tools needed. You have over 2 inches of adjustment forward and back. And if you choose not to run a backrest, the bracket's built into the seat itself, and removal is as easy as pushing down and pulling out. The final thing that I'm going to talk about is our new passenger backrest. Two big issues that the OEM section had was in support and space. We solved both of those by building in passenger armrests in every one of the ultimate passenger backrests that we offer. And the big thing is we were able to reshape the passenger backrest to give you an extra 3/4 of an inch of much needed room. It's been really great to be here at the WingStuff Remote Rally. Go to wingstuff.com to find everything that Ultimate Seat has to offer for GL1500s, GL1800s, all the way from 2001 to 2020, all the different models, and the Honda F6B.
Everyone, Rick from WingStuff.com, and welcome to the WingStuff Remote Rally. As many of you already know, WingStuff has its own brand of accessories and products for the Honda Goldwing, and that's the WingStuff brand. So I just wanted to tell you a little bit about that because I'm in the middle of that. I help design all this stuff, and we're very focused. We don't try to carry everything for the Goldwing, but we're very focused on luggage, motorcycle covers, belly pans, organizers for your trunk and saddlebag. So, years ago when I started WingStuff, I decided there were some products that I just wasn't happy with that were out there, textile products mainly, and I decided to redesign and make my own. And I did that, and we made the 3-piece luggage liner kit for the older 1800, reinforced corners, beautiful material, fit nice, everything that I liked at an affordable price. So just an example of one of the products that we've become very well known for because we put a lot of effort in designing it right and using good materials. And it's not something that 5 years later, the seams are gonna split. I wanna put out real high quality products. So another example would be our belly pan. We're the only company that I know of that has a stainless steel belly pan for the GL1800. And on that older 1800, of course, as you should know, there's a plastic coolant tank under that bike and there's no protection for it. It's wrapped with some kind of aluminum foil, and all it takes is a rock or some debris off the road to hit that, and you're gonna have coolant all over the road and it's just gonna be a bad day for you. So with a simple 2-piece belly pan, you can protect your bike and help eliminate that happening. Also has Zeus fasteners, which are aircraft quality Zeus fasteners to take the front piece off to change your oil instead of that cheap metal screw that a lot of companies use, and after a while it strips out, and it's bright polished stainless steel. So again, I try to put a lot of quality into the products that I'm offering you guys, and I also try to make everything as affordable as possible as well. We also have organizers. We have organizers for your trunk lid. We have organizers for the lower trunk. We have organizers for the saddlebag. And even into the 2018 model, we have a trunk organizer for the lid. We also have a lower trunk organizer for the new bike. We have a beautiful premium cover for all the Goldwings, and including the 2018 Plus. Our premium covers are 100% waterproof, and I'm not reading from a cue card. We use the best material that we can source. And I could have easily used the cheaper material. I didn't want to go that route. That's why it is waterproof, and that's why it lasts for years. So we have a beautiful, beautiful quality premium cover for this bike and the older Goldwings. We also offer some lightweight covers if you want something that's not 100% waterproof. And that's just kind of like on the fly. You just want to throw it on the bike for an hour, come out of the store, take it off, put it in the trunk. So we have a whole array of useful, functional things that we offer for you guys. Another example are our carpets. If you look at our carpet kits, I will put our carpet kits up against any other brand carpet kit. We use beautiful quality carpet. We have manufacturing connections overseas where we can get you quality carpet. Matter of fact, the carpets for the new Goldwing 2018 Plus, if you look at the quality of our WingStuff carpets, compare them with the OEM, you're going to find that our carpets are at least as good, if not better quality than OEM, for a whole lot less money. And they fit right. And so, you know, we can take the time to properly design the products that we sell to you guys. And we have helmet bags, simple things like that, with the fleece on the inside so it keeps your helmet from getting damaged. And it's waterproof on the outside. It has slots so that if you wanted to hang it on the outside of the bike, you can do that. So check out our WingStuff products. I think you're gonna like them. I put a lot of thought into designing all of them. And again, we're very focused on the items that we do put out there. And we feel that our products are the best of what's out there. And I'm gonna continue to do that with future new products as well. So hope you take the time to check them out and check out all the vendors on our WingStuff Remote Rally. So I hope you're enjoying yourself. Thanks for listening and ride safe, okay? Are you looking to protect your bike from outside elements like wind, rain, and dust? This premium, heavy duty, full cover from wingstuff.com is just the thing that you've been looking for. It offers next level protection, yet is compact enough to easily fit inside your trunk or saddlebag. 100% waterproof material combined with heat sealed seams and side venting keeps your Goldwing dry no matter what the conditions. Rust-proof lower grommets with double-stitched attached bungee straps. High visibility reflective piping. Reinforced antenna corners. The soft inner windshield liner gives added protection to your windshield. Every detail has been carefully planned out to ensure the highest quality motorcycle cover at the lowest price. WingStuff.com. We've got you covered.